Hello everyone, so welcome back to this channel, and today we will discuss about exposure to pesticides, and my name is Zohir Chaudhary. So when it comes to pesticide exposure, what we need to know is the various ways pesticides spread around in the environment and becomes a problem to human as well as the natural ecosystem. So in here, we can see the pesticide cycle in short. So you can see that once a pesticide is applied, the pesticide is absorbed by the crop, but can also be leached below the root zone by rain or irrigation, degraded by bacterial oxidation by chemical hydrolysis, as well as can adhere to soil particles. And when the rain comes in, that can be washed away and lead to surface runoffs, and that pesticide can go to lakes and rivers and accumulate in lakes and rivers. Beside that, it can also be leached into the groundwater, and from the groundwater can come into contact with the lakes and oceans or anything that the groundwater gets flows into. Some of the pesticides can be degraded by ultraviolet light, but it can also evaporate. And the pesticides that evaporate can drift with the wind and eventually deposit it far away or downwind from the application place of pesticides. Here you can see how the pesticide becomes integrated with the water cycle through the evaporation process, through the precipitation process, and the runoff process. So pesticides tend to be pretty water soluble, and as a result, it can drift in various environments and eventually finds its way in water, lakes, rivers, and oceans nearby. So who is at greatest risk to pesticide exposure? So of course, agricultural workers, those that apply the pesticides, but in addition, pets, children, and livestock are also at high risk, including sensitive population, such as pregnant women, elderly people, people with ill health and impaired immunity. So those most likely to experience the harmful effects of pesticides, as I just mentioned, include agricultural workers and other people who are unwittingly exposed to or misuse them. So employees who have been exposed to pesticides in the workplace unknowingly may endanger their family members as well as themselves. So workers' clothing may accumulate pesticides, which later may be carried into the workers' homes and contaminate unsuspecting family members. Pesticides may pose hazards to children, whose developing bodies are more sensitive to toxic chemicals than our adults' bodies. Some children are exposed to pesticides applied to pets when the children play on the floor, put their pets' toys in their own mouths, and put their hands in their mouths after petting the animals. Children appear to be more prone to pesticide poisoning than adults because children have large skin surface to body mass ratios. Children also demonstrate personal hygiene deficiencies such as hand-mouth behaviors that could cause the ingestion of pesticides. The pesticides used in agriculture may have undesirable effects upon cattle and other livestock. Exposure of livestock to pesticides may arise from contaminated feed, pesticides applied to fields, and agents used to control insect pests that plague food animals. The effects that animals may experience include acute and chronic toxicity, as well as toxicity to these animals. So pesticide residue may also build up in meat, poultry, and dairy products that subsequently are consumed by humans. Another concern regarding pesticides is what happens when they drift into schools and homes located near agricultural fields or near pesticide treated areas. Such drifting of pesticide may pose a greater hazard to children and sensitive populations, such as women and elderly and immunocompromised, than the general population. So, the various mechanisms of exposure to pesticide are shown in here in this diagram. So from water bodies, the pesticide can, by accumulated biomagnifying fish, And from there, it can magnify and transfer to mammals and birds who feed on fish or to humans who consume fish. From uncontaminated underground aquifers, the pesticide can be transferred into the potable water system. And again, human can have exposure to it. From the soil, air, the pesticide can come in contact with the crops as well as the cattle, and then the direct spraying of pesticides on crops or on insects can also be transferred, of course, into the crops and the animal and the livestock, which in turn, when we consume the meat or the dairy product, as well as the vegetables itself, we can be exposed to through ingestion pathways, dermal contact, of the pesticides during that handling and consumption process. At the same time, some of this insects, crops can also be eaten by mammals and birds, which in turn have exposure in that ecosystem. And of course, seeds by themselves also, they may be pesticides treated or they may have pesticide residue, which in turn, when mammals and birds eat them, they can be exposed to it. So that's a brief introduction of how exposure to pesticides can happen. I hope that you were able to learn something from this set of lectures. Thank you for listening, and please remember to subscribe to this channel.